Hello and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be showing you a Get Ready With Me video featuring a throwback palette here from my own collection. And then I'm also going to be dishing to you about my Makeup No-Buy year-long project that I've been on for 2018. I will be sharing with you what inspired me, how I've been successful, and then some tips for you if you would like to get started and try doing a project like this. So if you're interested in this kind of video, then just keep watching. All right, so my face has been washed. I do have some moisturizer and under eye cream on and some lip balm. And then also, before we get started, I do want to mention that I will try my best to let you know what I am using on my face. These are all products from my own stash. Some of them are from my November Shop My Stash. I'll link that video down below. And then also, I do have a little list here of the topics that I do want to cover. And if you see me looking this way, that is why. So that way I'm not just rambling. All right, let's go ahead and get started. The first thing I'm going to do before we get to my first topic is I'm going to spray my face with this Smashbox Photo Finish Primer. I don't know if this is like something that really does help my makeup, but I feel like it looks better and I feel better. I don't know. If you watch Chicago Med, then you'll know what I'm talking about when I say this reference. I don't know if I need to talk to Dr. Charles about this and ask him if this is all in my head, but anywho. So I'm going to spray myself with this. And then, of course, let that dry for a moment. Okay, and then, of course, while I prime my eyes, I'm going to be using my MAC. Let me grab it. I'm going to be using my MAC Soft Ochre Prolong Wear Paint Pot. And I am, of course, trying to finish this up. This is kind of where I am so far. And a little bad thing I actually did is I accidentally one day went somewhere and I had that open and I literally left the whole entire pot open. So I have been spraying it a little bit with this primer water just to kind of get it going. And then I'll dip my brush inside there. Anywho, let's get into the first one. I'm going to, of course, just be priming and setting my eyes with some RCMA powder right here, the original. I'm almost done. And I'm trying to use it up. All right, so the first thing I do want to talk about when we talk about my Makeup No-Buy journey kind of brings me back to when I first got into like high-end makeup. Now, I, of course, have always loved makeup and always wanted to know how to do makeup. However, I just really didn't know how. And to be perfectly honest, I, you know, I would wear makeup and such and I would buy the same exact products, probably I think that my mom bought, and I don't know why, I literally used to use this soft tan like powder, I guess, kind of like as my foundation. I use this Maybelline stick like under my eyes because I didn't really have bad complexion. And then I put this powder on, which of course this like soft tan was like not even matching. I mean, I'm dark, but that didn't even match me. And then I would also buy the same eyeshadow compact because I was obsessed with eyeshadow. I just didn't know how to do it. And I would wear this, what was it? All May eyeshadow thing. It was all about the eyes, little three trio thing. And I kid you not, it cracked all the time. It broke. And I would still buy it because it was supposed to be for brown eyes. It had brown eyes. And I thought that was like the thing I had to use, which of course, boy, was I wrong. And I bought that over and over again, which was fine. But I discovered high-end makeup, of course. And at the time, I was working two jobs, which was pretty awesome at the time. I'm going to start. Let me go show you my palette, the Kathleen Lights palette. This is an old one, of course. But if you have any eyeshadow palettes, you would have something like this in your collection. I'm simply going to be taking this little tan color right here. Putting that in my crease, and then I'm also going to add a little bit of this in my crease, and then I will cover my entire lid with this one right here. So just in case you're wondering, but I want to make sure I'm chatting. All right. So I, of course, like I said, I was working two jobs. I was teaching online, where I teach now. And then I was also, teaching full-time in a classroom, setting. I taught fifth grade and I had the extra money. So when I first discovered this whole like high-end world and YouTube, where there were people that could actually teach me how to use makeup and I thought I needed everything, I was spending a lot of my extra money on that. I was still saving, my finances were fine, but of course, like I said, I was buying a lot of unnecessary product, things that I, of course, did not need. Which of course was great for some things. Like for instance, I actually invested that time in some really great products. Like for instance, my Sigma brushes. That is something I never would be able to probably like splurge on or afford now. I mean, I could, but I wouldn't want to. I've always been pretty frugal, so it really shocked me when I let myself buy a lot of makeup for really high-end prices. And then, of course, I bought like the Foreo thing for your face. And then after like investing in good products actually needed, I just went crazy. I was buying all kinds of stuff, eyeshadow palettes, things I did not need, of course, and that was really dumb. And after that, like I loved makeup and I watched a lot of makeup tutorials and I was watching a lot of, I wouldn't say like the most popular people, I guess they were like bigger YouTubers and such, but I just fell in love with new releases. So that is, of course, needs to be addressed because this brings me to my next point, which was when I moved last year, and I have been mentioning this a lot in my channel because it's really affected a lot of like my declutters and everything. When I moved, I was going to have to be staying in an apartment for a little while and also staying with my brothers, and a lot of my stuff was going to go into storage. And of course, I didn't want my makeup to go into storage because, you know, it was in the middle of summer and I just knew that it would just go bad, etc. And I started looking at my collection. I had this big Rubbermaid bin. I have a video. I think it's my Makeup No Buy Rules where I show this bin. And I had that bin full. And then I also had another just like tons of Ipsy bags and like these little, like, you know, those little square, like drawers, like fabric drawers that go into like those big cubicles. I had several of those filled with makeup. And then I even had makeup where I'm like, I know I bought this such and such palette, but where is it? You know, and I'm never one to lose anything really like that. And that was great and dandy, but I just started looking at my collection and I pared down like my nail polishes. I started with that. And then, I stayed with my brother, like I said, for a little while. And my nieces, of course, are super obsessed with makeup. And so I started decluttering with them there. I really wish I had like started with the channel at that time and shown, because that would have been like a really awesome declutter video, like one of those satisfying ones. And my sister-in-law was literally saying like, Rachel, these are stocking stuffers. There was so much brand new makeup that I had never even touched, still in the package, that I was just giving them like little mini palettes from Maybelline and CoverGirl and all these things. And I had a lot of high-end stuff, brand new eyeliners, mascaras, a lot of my ColourPop Super Shock Shadow colors, like blue and weird yellows and like colors I was never going to use. Like, why did I even buy those? And then I, of course, just like gave them to them, and that was really great. So pretty cool. All right, we're going to get into the face now. I am going to be using this little sample I had. I used it once and twice, and I really love it. It's It Cosmetics No or Number 50 Serum Collagen Veil Anti-Aging Primer. I would love to buy this, but it is like super expensive, but I'm going to cherish this little sample while I can. Anyway, so that brings me to number one, I had a lot of money to spend at first. Number two, I moved and started decluttering and seeing all the makeup and was pretty ashamed of myself, but not too ashamed. I mean, I was still buying. and then the third thing, I actually ended up leaving my full-time teaching job from a full-time classroom, and I started teaching online and then just working from home, which was great. I was still buying a lot of makeup and everything, but I didn't have that extra money. My finances were fine, but I started to really see that year, like, why am I buying all this makeup? I kid you not, there was a 21 Days of Beauty, like the fall time, or it was either that or a Black Friday deal or something. And I literally like bought 17 Ofra liquid lipsticks. Now, a little bit passed and I decided that that was ridiculous, and I took like all of them back. I think there was one I couldn't find. I don't know where it's at even now, but I took all of them back because I started realizing that this was like a really bad habit. And I used to see people on YouTube, Instagram and everything, and they would talk about how like they were on this makeup no buy, but like, oh, sorry, today I went to Ulta and I bought more makeup. And I'm like, man, these people can't do it. I can't do it. Like, what's gonna happen? Maybe I can't do a little no buy, because I started thinking about it. And then finally, you know, I was just like really discouraged and I didn't do anything about it. Well, after Black Friday, probably around this time, today is the 17th, and I'm filming this before Thanksgiving because Black Friday's coming, and I thought maybe this could encourage somebody. And then also I have like family coming and everything, and my mom has like a whole week off, so I know that we're not gonna get anything, I'm not gonna get anything done on YouTube. So it was around this time last year that I started like thinking about it and of course looking up and researching, and I found two YouTubers. And then from there, I started finding other YouTubers that I even follow now that are some of my favorites I'd never heard of before. She's a smaller channel at the time. She's grown greatly, but her name is Too Much Tash. And I have mentioned her a little bit before in like other videos. And she, of course, at the time last year of this time, you know, November, was doing a year-long makeup no-buy. And when I saw that title, like it was like, my year-long makeup no-buy, you know, how am I doing, or update, I don't remember what. And I was like super intrigued, and I was like, somebody's doing a year-long makeup no-buy, not even like a month. And I was like, whoa, I've got to watch this. So I started watching her video, and she had so far not spent any money like on makeup for an entire year. And I was like, whoa. So then I started binge watching her channel, and she had of course linked like the original video with her like rules and everything. And I really got into her channel. And from there, I learned a lot of really great tips. And I'll talk about those in a little bit when I talk about my tips. But one thing, of course, was just like that you could do it. That's something I learned from her. And then, of course, like cataloging your makeup. And that was one thing I found from her. And then because I think a lot of her videos were about like, you know, using what you have and like being thrifty with your makeup, somehow I found Thrifty Beauty. Now, Thrifty Beauty has like a couple of... or a video I can think of that I'll try to link down below, where she talks about how makeup no buys, how she really thinks you just need to like kind of, I guess, basically change the problem. Like you can't just say you're not going to buy makeup for like a month and then you're just going to fall back into the same like trap and everything if you don't, you know, like change your ways. And so that is one thing I would agree with. This makeup no buy has really like changed my journey and how I spend makeup or spend money on makeup. And that's one thing I learned, of course, from her. And then also, one thing is that Thrifty Beauty, like her whole entire channel, of course, is about being thrifty with your beauty products. And she, of course, really showed me the aspect of having a goal. I don't know if she's ever done, like, I don't think she's ever done, like, a year-long no-buy, like, Too Much Tash. But I do know that I followed her as she's talked about goals. Like, she had a car repair or something, like a really big one that she had to like pay for. And then she also talked about like different credit cards. So she always like has some kind of goal, and you know, as far as I know, always achieves it and has been like a really big inspiration for me. She's younger than I am, but I mean, that just goes to show you everyone is your teacher. It does not matter how old they are. You can learn something from anyone. Even if it's like a kid, like there's some kind of video about this kid like hugging everybody and everything, and okay, being kind to people is something you can learn from this little tiny kid. You know, having no respect for the person and just loving people. So I learned that from her. I'm using my Tarte Shape Tape in medium. This is one I'm almost done with. and so, of course, I started doing my researching and started getting inspired by those people and realizing that I could do it. And then from there, I kind of made my game plan. And I'm going to share that with you. Now, I'm not going to go too in-depth in all of the five, I guess you could say, I think they have like five tips. Yeah, I have five or six tips here. Look at my little notes. I'm not going to go too into depth of each one. If you're interested in like a video about that, I would love to, because I couldn't talk about all of my tips in like one video. I'd be here for like forever. So the first thing that I would say, if you are really serious about doing a no-buy and you're like, I want to do this, I think I can do this, or whatever your reason, like I said, you're going to have a goal. My nose itches right here. So I'm removing foundation, but my nose itches. I'm going to give you my five tips on how to kind of like make this happen. The first thing, of course, is to, number one, is to have a goal. I think that's really, really important. Especially, like I said, I've seen people that were doing like no buys and they're like, I'm going to do a no buy. And now, it doesn't mean you necessarily have to have a goal. Maybe your goal is just to see if you could do it. And that is a goal, you know, seeing if you have the willpower. But I would say having a goal is to do it. one of my goals, of course, I have a lot of different goals and I'd love to maybe make a video about this, but one of my goals was, of course, just to save money in general, because I realized I was spending too much money. I could have put more into my savings account than what I was putting. So I would say, of course, with that goal is to tell someone about it, like whether it's your friend or a significant other, or make a video about it. I mean, originally my channel, the whole reason I made this channel was just to kind of document my no buy year. And I know there are people that have done that, been really successful. But my first video about like my makeup no buy, which I'll talk about that a little bit, was not very good. And I wasn't really in a place to be recording. And then also, I had two brothers who ended up in different accidents, not caused by themselves. And one even had to have surgery, and they were like here with me. Like I had them, stay with me and recover. And you can't, I mean, you can, but I'm not going to tell somebody who's like recovering from like surgery, hey, can you be quiet for like 3-4 hours while I record a video? Okay. Thank you. let me know if you need anything. Also, like I said, I wasn't in a place to like be recording. I think I'm in a much better like mindset, and now I don't feel worried if people find this video. I used to worry like, what if somebody I know finds that I have a channel? But now I'm like, whatever. I've made some great friends here that have been following me now, and I mean, we're friends, so it doesn't bother me. But I would say post about it. If you're too embarrassed and don't want to do a channel, first off, do it, please. Please, we need more YouTubers that are genuine and like real. I love those. I've been following a lot of more, I guess what you call micro influencers, and I've been loving it. They're my favorite. I do follow a few larger channels, but I looked at my feed and most of them are smaller channels. So make that video. Come on, do it. I'm doing it, and I don't, look at this. I'm not an artist. anyway, so post it, tell someone about it, do an Instagram post, do something, but tell someone. It's just like, you know, when you're trying to change your mindset, just like a diet, you know, you have to just change your habits, not just do like a diet for a little while and then come back and then just pig out and binge. But also sometimes telling people about it can be helpful, because then you feel like you have to be accountable. If you slip up, of course, don't let people discourage you and beat you down over it. I mean, everyone's human. Just like in a diet, you might mess up or have a weak moment or whatever. But I would say post about it. I think that's the best thing that you can do. And of course, go in with the mindset that you are going to make it, not like, oh, well, I'm probably going to cheat at Black Friday, things like that. This is my e.l.f. little e.l.f. mini compact, and it is called Fiji Matte. And there's, of course, just like a bronzer that I've hit pan on, and a little blush. So that's what I'm going to be using. So that is the first thing I would suggest. And I can give you some... I can do another video all about goals, but like I said, mine was mainly about saving money and such, and there was a little bit more into that in my personal life, but that was just one of them. The next thing is to find people who are successful. You know, go follow them. Maybe you can be like a support system, just like the buddy system for like, you know, fitness and everything. Find people that are successful. I would greatly suggest Too Much Tash, Thrifty Beauty. Like I said, Thrifty Beauty isn't like on a no buy or anything like that. Neither is Too Much Tash anymore. But they just have like really great tips. Go binge watch Too Much Tash and her old videos from last year, 2017, and you will get some great tips. And that is one of them, is just to follow them. Unfollow videos or even people or Instagram feeds that, of course, encourage you to do nothing but just buy makeup. Sometimes those posts that are like, I don't know what page necessarily, I think there's probably a few of them where they give a lot of like tips, or not tips, but like these memes of like, well, bank account says this, this and this, I need groceries, only $50 for groceries, what am I gonna do? Well, buy makeup. Okay, I kind of hate those because I feel like they encourage people to like buy stuff you don't need. Like if it's down to like gas and like, or food, or paying your rent or water bill. And I've seen little memes and stuff about that. Pay your rent and your water bill. I mean, you don't need that newest palette, you know. Or they'd like, you know, just sometimes I've seen like different companies make little jokes like that, and they're like Instagram, and then like people are like, holla, like people are like all excited about it and like, yep, this is the truth, this is so me. I love it. And I'm like, really. And I mean, and by all means, I'm not saying it's their fault that people buy makeup. You are obviously the person's in control of what you spend. You know, I would never say it's their fault, which, because it isn't, but I don't think it should be encouraged, of course. Let's see here. Another thing I'm going to be using is the Ciate Glow 2 highlighter. You know what? I'm not going to use this because this is in my November Shop My Stash, and honestly, it's not touched, so I don't even want to use it. So let's just put it out there. I'm gonna do the bigger thing. So I'm gonna reach in here and grab whatever highlighter I can find. Anyway, so that is one thing I would say. Like I said, unfollow people that don't help you in this thing or that are gonna encourage you to just buy more makeup. You know, companies, you know, there's a lot of channels that I watch that I really, really love. I'm gonna pull out the Mary Luminizer throwback highlighter here. There are a lot of companies, like I said, that I follow because I like them, and there's a lot of YouTubers I watch where I watch anything that they post, even if it's new makeup. Like, I really like Kathleen Lights, and even when she posts like a That's Expensive video, I love it. I will watch it. I don't have any problem with that. And Emily Noel, there's so many people, Jessica Braun. And some of, there's a few people that I will watch no matter if they're using like new makeup or not. But I of course don't want to, I don't follow or watch, or I say you might follow them, but I don't watch a lot of people's videos about new products. Sometimes I find myself skipping them because I'm not buying new product right now. And so it doesn't interest me. So if that's a problem for you, then of course don't follow them. Another thing I would say is number three. So number one is have a goal. Number two is to find people who are successful. Number three is to catalog your makeup. That is one of the biggest things that you can do. It is very eye-opening to see what you actually have by looking at your makeup collection. That was the real, like, okay, you've been hearing about the truth and like people over anything, beauty community in the world telling their truth. That was like the truth for me, man. Was like, whoa, I have how many highlighters and I don't even really like highlighter. That was one thing for me. So catalog your makeup. That is something I learned from Too Much Tash. She has a video, and I think in one of her videos, she shared like a, she shared about somebody who actually has like a document that you can use. So that is one thing there. And then the next thing I would say is to make some rules. I'd love to do a video about how to choose your rules. If you're interested, let me know. I'll tell you, we can talk more in depth about my own rules. Now, I made a video about my makeup no buy rules, and I'm gonna link it up here or link it down below. Go watch that video. You will laugh your socks off because I was so embarrassed about like starting a channel and being on the internet that I literally was like, these are my rules. I didn't even show my face. I showed like things, like when I was talking about cataloging my makeup, I had my laptop like, and here I am, blah, blah. You know, it was definitely a humbling experience. If I did that like small YouTuber tag, that would be my video that I would be like, fail. Like, if you ever watched The Office and like there's an episode where Dwight and Oscar are talking and he's like, okay, if you watch The Office, you'll know the spot. But he's like, where, Dwight? Where? And Dwight's like, you know where. And Oscar's like, okay, if you're an Office like fan, comment down below if you remember that episode. But that was what I was like when I cataloged my makeup. Okay, so that is one thing I would say, cataloging my makeup, of course, and then making my rules brought me to that. Okay, so the next thing I would say, I'm going to try this purple eyeliner. The next thing I would say would be to number five, stay away from stores. Etc. And this kind of goes along with like the posts, like I said. You know, I know that there was a person I was following and they were like, today I went to Ulta and I bought blah, 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 blah. Don't go to Ulta. I mean, like, drive by, change your route if you need to. But that is one thing, stay with the stores. There are stores I will not go to. If I'm like, you know, short on cash, I won't go to Target, because if I go to Target, I'm gonna have to sell my soul to Target to pay for all the stuff that I buy in the dollar section. So don't go into stores that are tempting for you. If Black Friday, let's say you're in a no buy right now, or maybe you're looking at your account and you're like, I need to afford Christmas presents or gas, whatever. Plan something different to do during those Black Friday deals when they're gonna hit live. And I know some of them are live now, like they're cyber little deals. go, you know, plan a game time with your family, go see a movie. My mom and I have some plans for after Thanksgiving dinner has been eaten so that we don't really go shopping. So do something like that. You know, stay away from those stores. That's one of a big tip there. And then the last one I would say would be to start some kind of creative project with your makeup. It doesn't have to be like a full-fledged like project pan. If you get tired of using the same makeup, which I do, so I've not done like a project pan. There are a couple things in my there's a couple things in my collection that I really want to try to just use up because like they're getting old. Like my RCMA powder, that MAC paint pot, things like that. So start some kind of project like that, or do a shop my stash, or you know, if you like Project Pan, to do something like that. But do something that's gonna make you not bored. Check out Meg's Makeup 8. She did her own advent calendar. I know you're not supposed to do this, but I have to. She did her own advent calendar, and she is, of course, putting like a project together with like colorful products like lip colors or eye colors, eyeshadow colors. And she like made her own advent calendar box, and then she also has like a bag with different 24 different products on slips of paper, and she like pulled from them and is putting them in this box. I'll link her video down below. Do something creative like that. There's another YouTuber I will mention, which is her name is Mykella, I think it's Dixon. She's so beautiful. If I could pick like a hair color and like face color and like aesthetic, it would be her. She did a 7 looks 1 palette with the Modern Renaissance, which is like, if you're a makeup junkie, you probably have that palette. And she said she was still thinking of other colors that she could, or other like looks that she could do. Do something like that. Get creative. I'm gonna put my lip color on here real fast. This is the MAC Celina Amor Prohibido. Sorry to all the Spanish people out there that speak Spanish. I don't speak Spanish. I am ashamed. I really am. So find some kind of project like that and make it happen. All right, I am going to pause this video, and I know I've chatted so much, but I'm gonna pause this video and pull down my hair and get my hat on because I'm gonna be heading somewhere, and then we'll close out this video. Alrighty, this is the finished look. I do not do my eyebrows, by the way, because I have Brooke Shields eyebrows. So that's just what it is. It looks great on camera, but not in real life. Anyway, thank you for stopping by. I hope that you would hopefully feel inspired, and maybe if you're thinking about doing this type of project, that you would realize that you too can do it. If you're interested in some more detailed ideas about how I've made all of my tips succeed for me, then please comment down below, like this video, please subscribe, and just stick around. Alrighty, thank you for watching. Wish me luck as I go and try to get a haircut to get this together. Thanks for watching. Bye, everyone.